What we have here today is a 93 GMC 1500. It's going to become a pickup box trailer. Now the story on this truck is that I bought it for a case of beer, used it at the farm for a bit till I blew the motor. It's only got 345,000 clicks on it. Basically the front ball joint separated on me. Just about everything else is wrong with this truck too, so I'm not too hurt. Got a homemade bush bumper on it, made out of Unistrut. It's pretty tough. I bumped into a couple things. Now, how you make a pickup box trailer is you basically cut the truck in half. Most people take the cab off and pull the engine and trans. I don't have time for that today, but I need a trailer. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna leave everything intact because I need the rad and the master cylinder, and I'll keep the alternator. Anyway, so instead of taking the whole truck apart, cut some holes in the floor, cut the exhaust, cut the back cab mounts. Gonna cut through the lines there now, just with my snips, and crimp them so they don't leak brake fluid or gasoline everywhere. The gas tank's still in the truck. I'm gonna take that out once it's in half because it'll be easier for me to get underneath it. Because what this is I just have two railroad ties underneath the truck on the box half. That means the front, it's kind of like a teeter-totter, it's pretty well balanced right there. So when I cut the frame, because I'm going to cut it right there, my goal is then I can just pick the back of the cab up and flip the whole truck over, because it's pretty light. Like, as it is, this truck only weighs, I think, 3,600 pounds or something like that. So if I hook my cable into the back of my truck, give it a yank, I'm sure it'll just flip over. As you can see, we had some fun with the windshield. So I guess I'll I'm gonna cut the trans cross member. I would like to keep that piece of steel, but it's just not worth it because the bolts are fucked, and then you gotta do different bullshit. So I'm just gonna sawzall it through on both sides, and we'll see how this goes. Two back body mounts cut. We got both fuel lines cut, both brake lines cut, the parking brake cable cut, exhaust cut. I think that's it besides the frame, so we should be good to cut the frame now. We'll see how this goes. Well, the one side's cut. It's almost straight. I'll have to fix that with the angle grinder, but actually maybe I won't. I don't know, we'll have to see. Right now, I guess half the truck's just kind of resting on the floor of the cab here. The back half's not too rusty, so it shouldn't fall through. Well, the truck's in half, as you can see. You got that space there, and we got frame cut. Now let's pull it apart. Well, the truck's in half, and it's only 12:21. I got here about 9 o'clock. Okay, well, I think I skipped a couple steps here. We're becoming a trailer now. I got my little digital welder out here that was $200 to my house off Amazon. Got a 100-foot 10-gauge cord running to a 5,000-watt generator. I've never actually seen how high this welder will go off this generator. The highest I've ever needed it to go is 130, and that generator does it just fine. So basically, we notched the frame, bent it in, and cut a piece out to set my piece of tubing in there. That's 3x2x1/4-inch wall rectangle tubing. I found that in the snowbank, actually. You see how I notched it? I did a straight cut, then only angle on one side. Just that's how I felt like doing it. I know you're supposed to bevel both sides, so the seam is all the way across, but it's not going to really matter. I guess I'll take another bit of video in a bit. The reason I can't take video of me doing stuff is I don't have an actual camera or a tripod or anything. I'm just filming this on my phone. It's all done. I'm just packing up to head home, because it's about an hour home from here. So how it worked out in the end is, so I notched it and I welded it on the top and on the bottom. And then what we have here for the actual coupler part, because I got just the straight coupler super cheap. It got on clearance for like $10 or something, whereas the A-frame couplers were like $30 or something. So yeah, I didn't really care in the end, but this is how it worked out. So I've got this 2x3/4 inch wall rectangle tubing welded in there with a piece of 2x2x3/16 on the, maybe that's 1/4 inch on the back side. So that'll be good. I just gotta get some safety chains for it and a plug for the lights, but I don't need that right now because I'm just gonna use this out here this year. Next year I'll use it as my scrap trailer. Mosquito. Yeah. Eventually, I've got a 4,000-pound trailer axle. It's under a camper. It's a camper axle. That will eventually go underneath this to make this actually legal, because there's no brakes and so forth. You need brakes on trailers in Manitoba. So this is how it worked out. It's not bad for what it is. It cost me $10 for the coupler, probably $5 in consumables, and bought the truck for a case of beer. So it's a real cheap trailer.